Ahoy, this is Zdenka. With all the new cameras popping up on the market everywhere, shooting in 4K and 8K, you might want to create and upload videos in 4K. But if you do have a slower computer, like me, for example, you will run into a lot of problems editing 4K footage. The computer will struggle, it will freeze on you, it will crash, you will have to restart it thousands of times, you will waste a lot of time instead of edit very fast. And I know, because I went through that. I actually got to the point that I wiped out the whole computer, I've installed a fresh copy of Windows and I just redone everything. And with the help of proxies, I can get my 4K video done very quickly. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create proxies and how you can use them to edit the 4K video footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. And for those wondering, yes, you can create proxies in DaVinci Resolve as well, which I will show you in the future. But right now, I need to actually update my graphic card on a computer because I simply cannot run DaVinci Resolve on the system. So for that reason, I'm gonna be showing it in Adobe Premiere Pro. Yep, I've got some computer war going on here. What is a proxy? Very simply, it is a duplicate of your original 4K video in a low resolution in a better codec. So when you're editing, you're getting this instead of this freezing action when you're editing large files. So when you will be editing the video, you will be working with the low resolution files, but don't worry, they will be directly linked to those 4K very high quality videos. And then once you export the whole thing, the program will automatically work with those 4K files. So then it will render the high quality video while you will be enjoying your break. Some of you might say, but you can drop the playback resolution to half, quarter, 1/8. But if that's not working, proxies will help. Now, most of the cameras use codec H.264, which is very hard to edit in 4K or even 1080p if you have a slower computer, like me, for example. It will take some time to create proxies. So if you are a vlogger which needs to edit the video the very same day, it might be a little bit difficult for you. But if you can convert the files, let's say overnight, you won't regret it because it is such a huge difference. You will save yourself a lot of time editing. There are a few ways of doing it. I'm gonna show you a very easy way, and also I'm gonna make it a little bit better because I'm gonna show you how you can create your own custom preset. I'm going to open up Adobe Premiere Pro 2020, my current version. I'll create a new project and import 4K files I'll use in the video. If I add them on a timeline and play them, you can see how choppy and slow it gets. So what I can do, I can right-click my imported clips and select Create Proxies. Select Format QuickTime instead of the H.264, and then in the preset, you have some choices here. Let's just select ProRes Low Resolution Proxy. Select folder where you want your proxies to be saved. I'll just create one called Proxy and hit OK. Now what will happen? Adobe Media Encoder will open up and in the background, it will create those low resolution files. You can actually watch them being encoded here at the bottom. And that would be a quick solution. So when you go now to your media browser, you can see your proxies there in the folder you just created. Adobe Premiere Pro automatically links them to the big files. So now when I place the file on the timeline and select toggle proxies, by the way, if you don't see the icon there, just hit the plus sign and drag the toggle proxies icon there. Now that would be great, but there is a problem. It makes me kind of nervous because I don't know if I'm working with the proxies or if I'm working with the 4K files. I simply don't see anything written over the video like a copy or proxy. I would like to see visually the difference between those proxies and 4K files so I don't get mixed up. For that reason, I'm gonna show you how you can create your custom preset. Let's do it. I am going to close Adobe Premiere Pro and open Adobe Media Encoder. Go to Preset, Create Encoding Preset. I'll name it a little bit later. Let's go to Format, select QuickTime, which will be much easier to work with than the H.264. Let's move on to Based on Preset section. Here we are going to choose Apple ProRes 422 Proxy. Now let's move on to video section below and let's look at the basic video settings. And here we can see that the width and height is the same as the original file, so it's very big. And that's not good, it's not gonna help us. We actually want that tiny little file so it works much faster. I'm going to uncheck that. I'll make sure select to maintain the frame aspect ratio is selected and make it smaller to 1280 by 720. Everything else we are going to leave the same. Let's go to effects where you will clearly mark those copies so we know we are looking at proxies, not the large 4K files. Go to name overlay, under prefix I'll type copy, or you can also type in proxy, whichever word you want. Format, change to prefix and suffix only. Position, I'll choose to bottom right or whichever you prefer. Size, I'll do 10 because I don't want the word too big. And opacity 0 as I don't want to see any kind of a box or background behind the word. And now we are going to name the preset and save it. Now, I don't know how about you, but because I like everything super simple, I'm just gonna add my name to that preset. You can add yours. So when you actually be looking at those presets, you will know, oh, that's the one I just created. That's actually the one I'm gonna be using over again. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in proxy 720, because that's the size of the video, Zdenka. And of course you can do proxy 720 John or Martin or whatever name you have. The saved preset will show in the bottom under preset browser. Now we created encoding preset. What I have to do next is to create ingest preset. Simply right click on the proxy 720 Zdenka or your name and create ingest preset. I'm going to name the same, just add ingest word to it. So proxy 720 Zdenka ingest. Let's go below, select transcode files to destination, choose format QuickTime and preset, select your proxy 720 Zdenka and hit OK. Now you can see your new ingest preset below. Now let's go back to Adobe Premiere Pro, right click those files, select create proxies, click on add ingest preset and type in the top corner search bar proxy 720 Zdenka ingest or your name there. It shows here. Click it and now it is here in the box. In destination, select folder where you want your proxies, those little files to be saved and hit OK. And that's all. So now again, it's gonna create those low resolution proxy files in a background. And once it is finished, just add those files, those higher as 4K files on a timeline. And now when I click the proxy button, I can visually see the copy word on my file. So now I know I'm actually looking at the proxies. And now I can edit super fast as they are automatically attached to large files. So next time you want to create more proxies in your future, for your future projects, you don't have to go through all this anymore because the preset will be already there. So all you have to do is just import the videos into Adobe Premiere Pro, right click, create proxies, and you will see the preset already there. This will save you a lot of time and surely did for me. Now I have to just go and buy a new graphic card, but that's a whole different issue. Hit the thumbs up if you like today's video and subscribe to all future videos like these. There's for sure more coming up. If you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi, you can do so in a comment section below. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao. Ahoy.